going to advance your left foot by doing an L. So the foot has to be parallel to the line or on a line. Shifting our weight, adjusting our dantian, making that adjustment, knees straight out. Sitting back, no problem, sit all the way back. Using our heel to twist out at a 45 degree, shifting our weight, heel out on an L stance, rotate our hips and waist, bow stance. Addressing dantian foot and head and torso. Sit back, twist step out, shift your weight, L stance, make sure that left foot is parallel to a line or on a line, bow stance. Sit back, twist step, shift your weight, L stance, over the knees, rotate, bow stance. Sit back, twist step, shift your weight, bow cow stance, rotate, bow stance. Good, just bring the hands together, sit back, twist step, shift your weight, L stance, open the knees, rotate, roll stance, here we go, sit back, twist step, left hand on the bottom, hold your ball, L stance, part the horse's mane, sit back. Twist step, shift your weight, hold your ball, L stance, serve your snack, just on it, sit back. Twist step, hold your ball, L stance, part the horse's mane. Half step forward, hold your ball. Rotate your ball to the left as you sit on your back foot. Lift up your hand, lift up your foot. White crane spreads its wings on its toes. Drop your front foot. Bicep, cut your body in half. Look back at your back hand that's higher. Step out, L stance, multitask. Turn your face, brush your knee. Not a knee movement, something we've already learned. Sit back, twist step. Look at your back hand that's higher. Bringing it to our ear. L stance. Turn our face. Brush your knee. Sit back. Twist step. Look at your back hand. Bringing it to our ear. Turning our face. L stance. Low stance. Half step forward. Sit back on our back foot. Play our loop on our heel. Here's our challenge for the day. Pulsing of the monkey, doing a backwards motion. Drop your front hand, drop your front foot. Open your both hands, back hand is higher. Palms up, lift, ear, toe, heel. Meet in the middle and pivot. Pulse your monkey. Open, look at your back hand. Lift, ear, toe, heel. Knee in the middle, push and pull. Open, look at your back hand. Bring it to your ear, set out your toe, heel, pivot to the middle, pulse your monkey one more. Open, lift, ear, toe, heel, knee in the middle, push and pull. Pivot your right foot, hold your ball on a T stance. Grasp the bird's tail, this time to the left first, or a big. Out with our heel, ward off, flip and meet, pull down, pull back, look back, turn, square contact, push, separate, sit back, push, up and forward, the other side, listen carefully. Pivot your left foot, sit back, hold your ball on a T-step, right hand on the bottom, grasp the bird's tail on the other side. L stance, ward off, push that opponent away, flip and meet, pull down, pull. Pull back. Look back. Turn. Square contact. Push them away. Separate your hands. Sit back. Push up and forward. Sit back. Cup. T-step. Just follow. Put the back hand in the front. Step out. Single leg in the front of you. Okay, I'll lift. Stay where you are. Alright. So, as best as you can, because I want to cover something, I mean, it's covered. This is single leg. Okay? Right. Yes. Stay right there. Do your single leg. Okay? Drop your left hand, pivot your left foot. Up. Middle or up. Flip me close. Middle or up. Flip me open. Middle or up. This time we're going to flip me close. This is the 24. Middle or up. One, open. Middle or up. Flip me close. Middle or up. Pull the back hand, look at it, step up, L stance, single leg. Okay, you can stand where you are to watch, or you can do it with me. Okay, I'm going to show you what other steps we learned, but still in 24, taken to 10. Half step forward, sit back, back your horse. Didn't learn that, it's 9 of 10. Cross at the wrist, step out. Heel down. We learned this one. Come up and came out. But it's taken out of context from the 24. We're doing another movement called double punch. Sit back. We're going to pivot. This time we're going to do the left kick. Left hand on the outside. Left foot coming up. We're going to keep out. Come in. And we're going to do a circuit. I'm going to continue because there's some students already here to show you that you're going to come down as if we were surfing in the grass. You're going to set, and guess what? You're going to be a golden apple standing on its left. We're going to put our toe down. We're going to do the surfing the other way. We're going to split. We're going to drop. We're going to be able to the right to set. We're going to come up, golden apple standing on its right.
Okay, and then we'll stop.
In the 10th form, all we do is keep our foot tight to posture, we center our hand, we look at it, we bring it to the middle, we push and pull. But in the 24, from the loot, we're saying, hey, this is repulsing of the monkey, this is repulsing of the monkey. And we're doing actually a backwards Tai Chi walk, which is safe for us. But who in their right mind would move their hands and body and do a backwards motion? Well, why do we do it in Tai Chi? Because it's a dance. It makes us that much more, it stimulates our mind. It gets our body to do things in more than one way, and but yet it's safe. And initially you say, I could do that. That's crazy to do something backwards. But every part of your body is helping you to become safe. Okay? So if you learn the Yang Tian form well, and you see or do the 24 like we just did, you can somehow make the connections and slowly, hopefully, be motivated to build up to learn the 24. Okay. That's fine right there. Any questions? So the serpent acts like this. We look here on our hook hand, we come down, and everything about where I put my feet and where I put my hands help me to be balanced. When I do the serpent one way, I have to do the serpent the other way, just like grasping a bird's tail. And this is called setting, and this is called, of course, golden cockle. But it looks very hard, and it is very hard, but all through the course of practicing, you know how to use your body, especially your dantian. We don't know what the downtown is now. We should really cue into what it is. And when I address that, when I say, be sure to address your downtown, what I'm trying to tell you in a short way is that your downtown is here, your foot is here, your hand is here, as if it was serving us that. It needs to be all centered. That's your best, safest way to be balanced.